welcome back again to the program Power Tonight with Elvira. Andito po tayo sa part 2 na ating magandang interview with Bishop Stephen Lee Bunsang. Siya po ang Auxiliary Bishop ng Diocese of Hong Kong at the same time Vicar General. Itutuloy po namin aming magandang discussion ngayon. Siya pong tunghayan niyo sa pagbabalik ng Power Tonight with Elvira.
May biyayang darating sa atin. Hinirang ang ating bayan. Pinili ang bansang Pilipinas upang dito idaos ang 51st International Eucharistic Congress.
Dadayuhin ng mga Katoliko sa buong mundo.
Saksihan natin ang real presence ni Jesus.
Pinakamalaking pagsasama ng mga mananampalataya.
May handog natin ang pinakamalaking selebrasyon ng banal na Eucharistia.
Ipakita po natin sa buong mundo ang lubos na pananampalataya ng mga Pilipino. Magkita-kita po tayo, ha? Sa Cebu.
Christ in you, our hope of glory.
Bishop Stephen, we were mentioning in our part one conversation that this information is also very important. Yes. So, how do you do that, you know, considering, you know, because I'm also guilty, you know. I'm so busy. Mm-hmm. I know I have to go to church, but sometimes I don't because my excuse is always that I'm so busy.
So many interviews.
Yes, mm-hmm. You know, not doing interviews, but doing other things, you know. Mm-hmm. So I'm also guilty when you're saying that. I said I'm one of those, you know. But anyway, but you know, it's so nice that you're so positive, you know, that you're really not telling it's wrong to do that, but you're still giving hope that you can still make it, you know. This is the message that I got, you know. Mm. There's nothing wrong. Maybe from time to time, we always fall down, you know, to our mistake, but you still have time to come up. This is your message.
Just, you like, give, just like now, when even during the interview, it's so easy because Our Lady is just next to us. When we are, I'm praying, I can be praying also in the interview. While I'm talking to you.
And it can inspire a lot of people, you know. Mm. You still can put Jesus into your life. Mm. You can still put your faith into your life while you are still busy. We are not telling you not to work, not to get busy, but still, but how to go about it is
the balance,
your work, the balance. So can't you give us an idea? What are these challenges that you think you can do or make something to inspire the young people that they can do something also to contribute a part of their life to the church?
Now, I think we are still in the process, of course. Always try to improve, always try to find better ways because we have to look for the sign of the times. And because the times are changing.
Yes.
And people, for example, 5 years ago, it can be different. It is different.
Yes.
So that we always try to look for ways to get in touch with them. That's the most important thing.
Okay.
First get in touch with them and then communicate, dialogue with them to see what their problems. And then we use our own example and or give them examples, life example, that it can be done. It can be done. Just like now recently we've been pushing promoting a lot of theology of the body of St. John Paul II. And then precisely I find that the feedback, the reaction of people, even the youths, are very positive.
Okay.
Now, so that is to give them ideals, rather than tell them that it's wrong.
Tell them
that what is good, what is God, what is your meaning of life, even when you are, what is youth,
what is
chastity. Now, then to challenge them, give them some challenge.
Yes,
and then they find that if they are challenged, and they find something that is that can because youth have their own strength inside. So you have to help them, to guide them towards to give the strength to help others. And then through helping others, if one finds God there. And so that's, we are looking for ways to dialogue with them, find ways to help them. And that's the way that we, there's no fixed way, I don't think. But we are using this line of action and then to keep communicating with them, keep in touch with them first.
You also understand that the youth especially need a lot of guidance. But in your word, you said there is so much beauty in the youth. And how to make them open up, how to make them feel that they can do something, something positive in their life is your task.
That's right. To help them to discover themselves, the beauty of God, the beauty of faith, that God is with them. And then God has created them to have a role in the redemption. Even though that they are young, but still also they have a role, a very important role.
So do you agree that not only in Hong Kong, But all over the world, in reality, there is still so much hunger for the words of God.
Yes, absolutely. Right? Absolutely. Not only in Hong Kong, but everywhere.
Everywhere.
Everywhere is the same. Because the more secularized, more materialistic the world, yes. the society, the yes. more they will feel the hunger for yes. God, yes. for the word of God, mm-hmm. and for the truth, for the good, and for the beauty. Yes.
So what do you think is the role of the Eucharist right now, especially that the 51st International Eucharistic Congress yes. will be held in Cebu, in our country. So how do you see the importance of this Eucharistic Congress? Let's say, apply it here in Hong Kong.
For example, the Eucharist, first of all, we have to convey, to communicate with them the importance of the Eucharist.
Yes. Yeah?
Both
yes.
for, first in the doctrine, first. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And then afterwards, to give them the example. And then they let them feel it, experience themselves, and then they will find the beauty of it. Mm-hmm. For example, now, here, we started a few years ago, and it works quite well. It's in every parish, there is the exposition of the Blessed Sacrament.
Adoration.
Adoration. You know? Uh-huh. One afternoon, every week, that one afternoon, and then used it. And even they apply to the youth. It can be, and sometimes it's, oh no, come on, they don't have the patience, right?
Yeah,
few
yeah.
hours sitting in front of the Blessed Sacrament.
Yes, yes.
It's unthinkable for youth.
Yes.
But they can.
Yes, yes. Yes.
And then we find them, like in the World Youth Day, right?
Yes.
They always have exposition. And I'm sure this international
Eucharistic
Congress, the same, they are part of it is for the youth, for the thing.
Yeah.
And then they are people. Yeah? The youths, that's why they have that strength to love. Mm? And then we have to help them to discover that love for God and the love for the Eucharist. Mm. And then once they do it, they will feel that they are so happy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Because they find the peace.
Mm-hmm.
And then they find they themselves, in fact, they need that silence.
Okay. Yeah?
They can keep that silence, and only the silence that they can keep in touch with God.
Mm-hmm.
And they can listen, mm-hmm. and God speaks to them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? And that's the personal religious experience
yes.
that we have to help them to go through.
Mm-hmm.
And that would, what I feel is that would deepen their faith.
Mm.
So through experience.
Through experience and giving them the opportunity, you know, through the Blessed
exactly.
Sacrament. You
we
know.
Give them the information
yes.
behind, the doctrine behind,
okay.
and then help them to have a chance to experience it
mm-hmm.
personally.
Mm-hmm.
And then they will feel the love of God.
Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. I agree with you because mm-hmm. in Quebec, you know, during the, I think that was the 49th, you know, International Eucharistic Congress, I remember they have this exposition of the
yeah,
Blessed
yeah.
for 24 hours.
Yeah, yeah.
Archbishop Jandu, at the time he was still a bishop, he was a very prayerful person,
mm-hmm.
especially for the Our Lady, you
mm-hmm.
know.
Mm-hmm.
And he went there at 12 o'clock midnight.
Mm-hmm.
He said he was very surprised to see all the people inside that Blessed Sacrament, you know, the Adoration Chapel, was all young people.
Yeah.
And they were all kneeling down praying for 2 to 3 hours.
Yes, yes.
That's why what you said struck me that you are right.
Yes.
The youth can be more prayerful than us. Without,
yeah, of course.
You know, we cannot say that, oh, they are
because
young people.
We fall
they
asleep.
Don't know. Yeah.
Tired already.
Yes, yes.
Old already.
Yes. But you know, this is one way of, you know, making them feel closer to God,
yes,
you know.
Yes.
And this Eucharistic Congress is also another opportunity for them to know God,
yeah,
to
yeah.
understand God,
mm-hmm.
to listen, mm-hmm. and to be able to talk to God, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is more of a personal encounter,
yes.
personal religious experience with God,
exactly.
right? So mm-hmm. what do you think, you know, because I heard you're going to send youth delegates to the...
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I think that would be nice because we will have one special day for the youth.
That's
and
right,
from what
right.
I heard, the activities will really
mm-hmm.
mix them because I was informed and told also that these activities for the youth, they will not only play a part, but they are actually, you know, part of the Eucharistic
yeah.
Congress,
yeah,
you
yeah,
know.
Yes.
So the youth will feel, wow, we are
yeah.
part of it, we are needed,
part of the
you
church.
Know.
Part of
yeah.
the church.
Because the youth right now are restless because they wanted to be of service. This is what I
yeah,
understand.
Exactly. Yeah.
They want to serve,
yes.
but they were not given the opportunity because we adults will say, oh, they're still young, they don't understand. But deep inside, but of course, the attention span is very short.
Yes.
They feel they would like to serve, but after few moments, they want to do another thing,
yes.
you know.
Yes.
But in your case, in Hong Kong, you are doing everything to really deepen more their understanding,
yes, yes.
right? So what do you think is the challenges that is facing Hong Kong right now? In spite of these several steps you are doing, what is the most difficult thing that you foresee in the, you know, in your country right now?
Now, still, it's still the same old problem. Mm-hmm. It's the fighting with the so many distractions, no? Materialism still, and it would be our main problem.
No? Okay.
Because there are many attractions, no? Through mm-hmm. the television, through the and then as well as all the now internet and the exploration in internet, mm-hmm. All this, as well as all many other the fun, so-called inverted commas, no? Mm-hmm. That would distract them from sometimes even from study, as serious as that, no? So that and this is all we try to help them to balance it, no? Not to say that they cannot have fun, but it's the fun also in God, no?
Okay.
To find something more interesting in the service for others, to mm-hmm. find that fun in it, no? Because the youth they need that the kind of enjoyment, but let them enjoy in God, mm-hmm. in God's service to others, and enjoy helping others. And but I would say that help the family, their own family, mm-hmm. because the youth tend to help others. But once you come home, and then they all take it for granted already. Mm-hmm. So that is the main thing, that to start from this charity, this order. Order in helping your own family first.
Mm-hmm.
That is one another area that we are promoting a lot, is the through the family, the World the Bishop's Conference.
Okay.
In the how do you call it?
World
Bishop Synod. The Synod for
Bishop,
families.
Yes.
And so we also echo that in a lot, in promoting a lot about marriage, family,
mm-hmm.
and that would, so that people can put the emphasis first, not only in working, but look after the family.